This is definitely sort of a left turn in my career, but that's okay. I mean, sometimes when you see a problem, particularly if you're a scientist, you want to go and take care of it.
Yep, and the only scientist on the ballot, so we need to have good education, we need to listen to science.
So there's a shakeup going on in the scientific community right now that's really kicked into high gear in the past couple of years. And Jess Phoenix has jumped into the fight headfirst. She's a volcanologist, a volcano scientist, who's also running for Congress. And she's not alone.
Hey there, my name is Sandy, and I am a volunteer for Jess Phoenix for Congress.
Phoenix is a Democrat running a grassroots campaign to represent one of the few congressional districts in California that's held by a Republican. It's an important district that political commentators predict could swing from right to left this November as the Democrats push to take back the House of Representatives. After more than a year of fundraising, phone banking, and rallying the voters, Phoenix isn't favored to make it past the primary. But until the polls are closed, Phoenix is still campaigning.
Hi, is it Shirley?
We need to continue to have scientists speaking out, because they lend a different approach than what we currently have. And anybody who wants to try and tell me that somehow lawyers are more objective than a scientist, that's a crock of crap.
So it's time for us to do what we do best as Americans and rise up.
Phoenix is part of a surge of scientists who have been chasing public office since Donald Trump was elected. One of around 60 people with ties to science who are running in an election that could shake up who sits in Congress. Right now, it's mostly lawyers. But this year, there are biologists, doctors, engineers, a stem cell researcher, and techies who jumped into federal races. And California's primary election is a massive hurdle for five of them, including Phoenix, on their way to Washington.
Well, it's bigger than anything we've ever seen.
That's Shaughnessy Naughton, the president of 314 Action, a political action committee that's working to get more scientists into elected office.
There certainly has been an unprecedented number of scientists running from everything from school board and city council up through the state legislature and at the federal level.
So why now?
I think scientists are speaking up and getting engaged now because everything Trump said that he was going to do, he's making good on.
Like pulling out of the Paris Climate Agreement.
So we're getting out.
And moving to scrap Obama-era restrictions on greenhouse gas emissions. The White House has also proposed funding cuts for key science agencies, which sounded alarm bells for scientists around the country. And running for office is one of the ways for scientists to grab a seat at the table.
As a scientist, you're terrified that the research you've worked so hard for, the things that you've studied, the things that you've wondered about are going to be taken away. So I think that there's a lot of people who have a lot to lose and a lot to gain.
Plus, in the era of alternative facts, Phoenix thinks that scientists have a unique perspective on reality that they can offer American voters.
So in politics, particularly in Congress, you're supposed to look at all available evidence and talk to experts when you don't know something and use that to arrive at your conclusion, or in other words, how you're going to vote on a given bill or a resolution. And we need people who are going to stick to that scientific way of addressing a question and say, okay, where is the objective truth here, or look as close as I can come to the objective truth.
The big question is whether American voters think the same. There are challenges for any political newcomers: money, connections, experience, and the fact that making policy isn't just about evidence, it's about people too. So for scientists, their analytical strength can also be a weakness.
I think, you know, politicians are fantastic of being absolutely certain whether or not the facts are with them. And scientists are, you know, that is a challenge for scientists. Scientists can be very literal, and politics is not literal, and politicians generally are not literal.
We're seeing those challenges borne out in the primaries leading up to November. Those 60 people running for Congress? Well, of the ones who have faced primary elections in their districts, only a handful have made it through. And for Phoenix, after more than a year of campaigning, the polls closed in California's 25th congressional district.
I am so profoundly grateful to all of you. And I mean, I'm going to get all teary, so I'm going to stop, but we should go look at the returns.
I just want to be on your
Only 4.8. Damn.
It was a loss for Phoenix, who finished fourth in her district with 6% of the vote. So is this surge of scientists running for public office going to fizzle out this year? After all, Phoenix doesn't plan to enter another race.
No, I still will not run again. People are going to keep asking me, and I'm like, no. Because, I mean, first and foremost, I'm a scientist, and I was never a politician to begin with. And I never wanted to be a politician. I have always wanted to be somebody who kind of transcends that career politician label. I haven't had to compromise who I am at all. And win or lose, I'm really proud of what we've done.
Her campaign wasn't a failure. It was an experiment. And in science, when you finish an experiment, you have data. Even if your hypothesis doesn't work out, and often it doesn't, that's still a contribution to human knowledge.
And obviously, if we don't open the doors for people, they can't walk through. So I see this wave of folks running, win or lose, as kicking down the doors.
We are not going to win races that we don't run candidates in, and we are not going to fully hold accountable elected officials if we don't challenge them each and every election.
Even if most of the scientists running for office never make it to Washington, they're collecting important data, their experiences. So who knows? Maybe the next wave of politically minded scientists can learn from it. Thanks so much for watching. We have a new video coming out every week, so please subscribe.